goes back to the question about doing it inside versus outside and the effects of being inside. I live in a climate that gets a lot of snow and it gets quite cold here. So what about doing it? What is your opinion about doing it outside? I'd rather do it inside, but what is your opinion about doing it outside when there's like several inches of snow on the ground?
他住的地方比较北一点，经常呢冬天有很多雪，好几寸的雪。他问这时候就是您的观点，在雪里边，比如说做气功啊，有什么讲究吗？这个问题真的是非常好，我很喜欢回答这个问题，因为我们中国人练功有句话，以及这武术界啊叫冬练三九，夏练三伏，夏天天气很热，我们也要练。
练得全身是汗处，冬天非常冷，我们也要在冬天雪地里面去练，这就是练我们人体的一种调剂能力，就是让我们人体的这个调剂能力更好地适应自然界的这个寒热的变化。And
in Qigong world, especially martial world, we're saying you want to practice in the hottest 3-7 days outside in the summer and the coldest 3-9 days, which is 27 days in the winter. And the reason is if you want to greatly increase your body's ability to regulate and to accommodate the nature, you do want to be able to take the extreme conditions.
你在夏天天气很热，夏天40度、35度啊，35度，你可以，当然这么热的时候，我们在外面当然你要不要让自己出汗的话，你要及时的补充水分。那如果出汗很多呢，要喝很多的水，就不要让自己这个吐水了。那也不要让自己太大汗的淋漓，就是在觉得适中的情况之下啊，就是也不要太出太多的汗。那稍微出点汗，在天气很热的情况之下，在室外练，那你说？
哎呀，在外面你还出汗呢，我就在室内开着空调练吧，把空调开得冷冷的，非常冷。这个汗很舒服，但是很舒服。我在里面练，这两个比较是哪个更好？我认为是在外面热一点，出一点汗。第一正好也驱寒啊，驱寒祛湿哈。对对，把你的这个病邪之气，
对对，
身体里面的这个毒啊，病邪之气，废物把它更多的排出，通过汗来排出体外。
但是如果你在室内，你说我开了空调练好不好呢？我认为没有在室外出一点汗，对健康的好处更多。Let
me further explain why. For instance, when outside temperature is 35 Celsius, about 96, 98 Fahrenheit, you go outside, you will sweat, and that kind of sweating actually is very, very beneficial to drive the cold and dampness out of your body. But the precondition is you protect yourself well enough from the sun and you hydrate yourself well enough so you don't get a heat stroke. This comparing to you stay in the AC room, you never even break a sweat and you're exercising and doing Qigong, you're wide open when the cold qi can even enter your body even more easier. So the two, when you compare, I would say the first one is a lot more beneficial because that sweat actually is through sweating, getting the diseased qi, the turbid qi, especially the cold and damp qi out of your body. But now not allowing our body to sweat and do things like that. And that's a lot of the issues, a lot of the problems coming from, okay.
当然刚才说在寒冷地区啊，因为你现在刚才问问题的朋友，他说在这个外面寒冷的天气，他那个下雪很，可能下雪现在已经进入下雪的天气了。其实对我来说，我是特别喜欢下雪天练的。我记得我在刚学这个功法的时候，在1990年前后，在87年、88年那时候南京下很多的雪，以前我们在大学上学的时候，我们就在那个雪地里面，很多的同学都在雪地里面去练功。
我在英国的时候，英国下雪不是很多，但是这个下雪的时候，我也喜欢在下雪的天气里面，在雪地里面去练功。And when you practice to a certain level, or when your own yang qi is extremely strong, actually you favor the cold weather when you have the cold weather, especially the snow, you want to go outside and practice. And I remember in the late 80s and early 90s, and a lot of our students at the Nanjing TCM University, when it snows, and it snowed quite a bit, we would all go outside and standing in the snow and do Qigong.
当然前提是你自己要感觉到自己的精神状态非常好的时候，你到雪地里面去练功。如果是你那个时候身体很不舒服，或者是你觉得很 weak， 那你就不要在寒冷的地方，因为毕竟寒邪对你会有影响。
Of course, this is the precondition is you yourself is so strong and your own protective qi and your body can take the cold. If you're so weak to withstand the cold and the wind, of course, don't go outside, okay, in the winter.
当然，尤其是在马不站桩的时候，那如果说更好，如果气温非常低，你最好呢，我还是建议你戴个手套，马不站桩。
If you do want to go out in that weather for a standing meditation, for instance, just cover yourself well, including gloves, including, you know, hat and scarves and everything. And the right shoes, very important. Yeah, in other words, you want to convert the cold yin qi to yang qi, but you cannot sacrifice or hurt your own yang qi. That's the precondition.
Okay.
So definitely don't get yourself too cold when you're outside doing Qigong and then got sick.